Lions in Africa get tuberculosis. Bengal tigers have gotten canine distemper. The critically endangered Saiga antelope, 210,000 animals died within a fortnight. Critically endangered wildlife are dying due to diseases, diseases they're sharing with dogs and humans. This is happening globally, not just with individual animals, but on a global scale with our fragile endangered populations. I'm Dr. Deborah McCauley. I'm a wildlife veterinarian. We founded VIEW, Veterinary Initiative for Endangered Wildlife, to address the missing piece to conservation, which is wildlife health.
We're in Chitwan National Park. It's a World Heritage Park. It has some of the most endangered wildlife in the world here. They have Bengal tigers, 200 Bengal tigers in Chitwan, about 500 to 600 greater one-horned rhinos. They have the critically endangered burial crocodiles and over 500 species of birds.
Tuberculosis is a disease that affects the lungs and causes pneumonia, and it affects people, domestic animals, and wildlife.
Did you have to wrap it at all? This
wound looks great.
Yeah.
It looks so good.
Of the 200 elephants in Chitwan, 24% of the elephants were found with tuberculosis, and we found the first case of tuberculosis in a rhino. Tuberculosis is one of the biggest problems on a global scale, and it's shared with all species.
We started our program here in Chitwan National Park in a threefold way. We have trained over 200 wildlife professionals on safe capture techniques and disease surveillance. We've also helped with their infrastructure, building a field laboratory, and they're building a wildlife health hospital. And Chitwan National Park is an excellent template to share with the rest of the world how wildlife health can be included into a wildlife conservation package.
Now we are regularly getting a herpes virus infection in a young calf below 5 years old. If animal get infected with herpes, the animal will die within 1 day.
This is a very recent kill of a tiger with a spotted deer. You can see the drag marks right down here, right next to the rhino tracks. And we just saw a whole group of spotted deer ahead of us. So right here in the forest, right in the tall grass, is a tiger with a recent kill.
So when you're out here in the forest, do you want to look around for signs of animals? And I always like to look at the trees on the tree trunks to see if there are any tiger scratch marks. And if you use your nose and you smell something that smells like buttered popcorn, that's what urine of tigers smell like. And so the last time I saw a tiger, we just smelled the tiger, and then we saw this big, massive male Bengal tiger.
Tiger is increased. Tiger came outside giving problem. They're taking buffalo, cow, whatever. And sometimes they take also people.
But I capture more than 100 tigers. We use the elephant. They push close to me. Then tiger comes. Then I can dart when the tiger comes. After that, takes 10 minutes. Then we'll wait. And then they go down, effect by drop. And then we'll put a radio collar, whatever. We have to find out something problem. That is the method we can capture tiger.
Tigers time is running out. This is an urgent issue on a global scale, but we're here to help and we can do this. Veterinary medicine has the ways for prevention and treatment, and we need to include it on the ground in the field to help our endangered wildlife in their native habitats.